Methods and Materials section of a research paper. The Methods and Materials section in a research paper comes immediately after the Introduction section and before the Results section. The purpose of the Methods and Materials section is to answer questions such as, which research method did you follow? Why? How did you do your work? What did you do? What did you use? What were the procedures in detail? Which devices, materials, and tools were used? What is the design of your research? The objective of this section is to describe exactly what you did, and how, in sufficient detail such that any average reader with the same resources will be able to reproduce your study. So, you cannot present the results of a test or analysis that was not mentioned in the methods. Conversely, if details of any or all procedures have previously been published elsewhere, then a brief summary will suffice, accompanied by reference to the relevant publication. In other words, the purpose of this section is to map the road that led you to the results, and to describe to readers the actual path of the journey you took to reach your destination. Begin this section by defining the scientific method that you followed, indicating the reason for choosing it and not others. This section of the manuscript should contain essential details for other scholars to replicate the study's experiences and help lay readers better understand the study. Remember to include in this section enough details, so that others with intermediate experience will be able to repeat your experience and reach the same results. Any reviewer of your article will focus well on this section to ensure that your experiments are repeatable over and over, and lead to the same results. In the event that he doubts the reproducibility of your experiment, or believes that you have hidden accurate details to prevent others from repeating what you have done to reach what you have reached, he will reject your article without hesitation. Because it will not be considered a solid research. One of the most famous reasons for rejection is that the reviewers did not fully understand how the researcher conducted his research. The details of the methodology differ according to the scientific field of the research. For example, in the fields of medicine, pharmacy, chemistry, physics and life sciences, in the materials section, mention the names of the solutions, reagents, and tools used, and mention the technical details, quantities, materials, method of processing, and properties of the materials used. Mention the scientific name of the substance used, but if you find that the effectiveness of the substance varies according to the manufacturer, mention the trade name with the name of the manufacturer. In the life sciences field, describe in the methods section the animal, plant, or microorganism experiments you have done, and mention the gender, age, family, breed, etc. In the fields of sociology, psychology and education, you must mention the most accurate details of the research population, the sample, its size and details, the type of data, quantitative or qualitative, and specify the independent variable, the dependent variable, the control group and the experimental group. Select your research tool, is it a questionnaire or an interview? What type of resolution? How many questions? Indicate the type of statistical test you used, why you chose this test, what statistical analysis software is used and its version number. In the field of informatics and computer science, specify exactly which algorithm, model and programs were used. Why did you choose this algorithm? Computer specifications, manufacturer, memory, speed. Steps to write the methods and materials section. Step 1. Define your research design. Is it prospective or retrospective, randomized or non-randomized, double-blind or open-label, controlled, crossover, factorial? If your methodology design is unusual, you should justify your choice by the appropriate references or guidelines, or an explanation of the specific context calling for your particular approach. Step 2. Write a description of whom or what you studied, the study population, animals, human subjects, cells. For the vast majority of clinicians, the study population will comprise human subjects, and so, the inclusion and non-inclusion should be detailed. The procedures for identifying eligible patients should also be outlined: consultations, new admissions, daily rounds, staff meetings, case review meetings, etc. For retrospective studies, the methods should begin with a description of the source data for the study, namely the inclusion and non-inclusion criteria and the final number of case records and/or patients selected. However, for prospective studies, the methods should describe the inclusion and non-inclusion, but the final number of patients included is considered as a result and therefore, should be indicated in the results section, and not in the methods. Step 3. Describe all the methods used to measure all the major parameters recorded in your study. Specify the primary and secondary endpoints, with the methods used to measure them. This is absolutely fundamental, since the choice of the primary endpoint is critical to the success of the study. It is the sole criteria that allows you to draw formal conclusions about the outcome of the study, and thus, must be carefully selected. For example, every blood test, intervention, operation, questionnaire, imaging technique, etc., should be detailed, where necessary providing the manufacturer details, manufacturer's name, city and country of company, for any specific equipment or tests used. Justify by short sentences why each measurement was taken. Subtitles can also be useful to separate the methods section into relevant subsections, demographic data, angiographic measures, treatment. Step 4. In some research fields, like medicine, you should include a short note about the ethical considerations by stating briefly that ethics committee approval was obtained for the study, or if not, explain why. You must also confirm that written informed consent was obtained from all subjects, or from their next of kin, or surrogate, where appropriate. Most journals request that the name of the ethics committee and the date of approval be specified, and some may even require the file number to be given. There may also be varying recommendations about where to include all this information. So, refer to the instructions for authors of your target journal. Step 5. In the final paragraph of the methods section, you should detail the statistical analysis. Standard statements about the presentation of the data should come first. For example, quantitative, normally distributed data are presented as mean standard deviation, or median interquartile range, for non-normally distributed data, and qualitative data as number percentage. Then, the specific statistical approaches used should be listed, which test for which type of variable, type of multivariate analysis and the variables included in it. Approach used for survival analysis. The sample size justification can be included here, stating the working hypothesis for the frequency of the outcome and its variance, the difference you expect to observe, and the alpha and beta risks used for your calculations. The level of significance for the analyses, as well as the software used, should also be included. Any planned subgroup analyses should be detailed in this paragraph, in order to avoid potential criticisms about post hoc studies in non-predefined subgroups. It must be remembered that planned subgroup analyses have an impact on the calculation of the sample size, and the use of multiple analyses may require Bonferroni's correction to ensure that the alpha risk is not inflated. The methods and materials section should include 1. Explanations and justifications. Usually, each paragraph or subsection in the methodology section talks about a particular experience. Early in each paragraph, explain the rationale behind your choices for that specific experience. For example, why did you use a particular compound, a particular strain of mice as an experimental model, or the particular concentration of that primary reagent? 2. Visual presentation. To help readers better follow the study design or methodology, visual elements such as figures, graphs, and tables can be used in this section to facilitate the assimilation of complex information. The journal editors closely examine the information in the methodology and methods section to assess whether the most appropriate approach has been used to reach your research objective. While you don't have to include every detail of your experience if those details are obvious and don't deprive others of the possibility of replaying what you've done. Important tips. 1. Stick to the given instructions. Read the author's instructions section of the target journal carefully and follow the specific instructions. For example, the title of the method and materials section of medical research may need to be changed to patients and method, methods and methods, or method and tools. You may be expected to follow certain standard guidelines such as those set by the APA. 2. Structure the section to tell the story of your research. All experiences should be presented in a logical way that helps the reader to keep track of the study's progressive development and nuances. A useful way to achieve this is to describe the curriculum in a chronological order of the experiments. For example, for a clinical trial, you could start with setting, study time, study start and end date, followed by patient assignment details, number of subjects, patients, etc. Study design, prospective, retrospective or otherwise, randomization, if found, group assignment, intervention, and description of techniques used to collect, measure, and analyze data. 3. Follow the order of results. To improve the readability and flow of your manuscript, match the order of the selected methods with the order of the results achieved using those methods. 4. Use of subheadings. Dividing this section in terms of experiences helps the reader to follow the section better. You can write the specific goal of each experiment as a subtitle. Alternatively, if possible, the name of each trial can also be used as a subtitle. 5. Accurately present all details. Provide the details you took into account during the study design or data collection because the smallest differences in these steps may affect the results, their reproducibility, and the interpretation of their significance. When using outcome measures, readers want to know information about validity and reliability. The correct way to report reliability and validity depends on the specific research design. Typically, information is provided from the existing literature to support the reliability and validity of the procedures. Carefully describe the materials, equipment e.g. test kits, technical equipment, or catalysts used in the experiment. If your study included a questionnaire or any psychological assessment, state the questionnaire, the methods of recording grades, and the validation of the scales with all possible details. 6. Start writing this section as you go through your research and experiments so you don't forget any details. 7. State ethical consent. If required, state early in this section whether your study was approved by an ethics committee, and whether you have received oral, written informed consent from patients or guardians. 8. Identify the variables. State clearly not only the control variables, independent variables, and dependent variables, but also whether there are any exogenous variables that might affect the outcome of your study. For example, in a tutorial on learning how to write research methodology, one group is provided with traditional text while the other group is provided with an interactive online tool. However, if some of the participants already had prior knowledge of how to write the methodology and materials section, this prior knowledge would act as an exotic variable. 9. Statistical analysis. In this section, describe all the statistical tests, significance levels, and software packages used to perform the statistical analysis. You can also consult your team's biostatistician to receive assistance in writing this section. Do not forget to indicate whether the recommendations of a knowledgeable statistician have been considered. Finally, it is important to provide a justification for the preferred statistical method used in the study. For example, why do you use the t-test? 10. Do not describe well-known approaches in detail. For the sake of brevity, avoid detailing experiments that are widely used or already published in many articles in your field. Instead, state and cite the specific experience and state that the indicated process was followed. However, if you have modified the standard process to meet the specific objective of your study, describe the modifications and their reasons in sufficient detail. 11. Do not provide unnecessary details. Avoid unnecessary details that have nothing to do with the outcome of the experiment. For example, you don't need to mention simple details like the color of the bucket that contained the ice. Try to stick to only the details that are relevant and have an impact on your studies. 12. Don't discuss the pros and cons of other methods. While it may be tempting to discuss your reasons for not using a particular method or how your chosen method is superior to other methods, save these details in the discussion section. Use only the methods section to remember the details of your chosen methods. Verb tense in the methods and materials section. The tense is the past, because you are talking about actions that you have previously done. Say, I used such and such a device, but do not say, we use, or, we will use. Use past tense when you describe the curriculum, materials, and procedures you followed. Examples. We collected tissue samples from, transcript levels were measured by RT-PCR. Past perfect tense when you describe an event that happened before another event. Example. Once the temperature set in the thermostat had been reached, the system was allowed to equilibrate for 30 minutes. Past continuous tense, when you describe a continuous or repeated action in the past. Example. Patients with relapsed and/or refractory whose disease was progressing after two or more prior lines of therapy were eligible to participate. To receive our upcoming videos, please like this video, and subscribe to Research Academy channel. Good luck.